everybody. Everybody get time to get stuff out. You're all good. Everybody feeling better. Ready for a second half of madness because it's coming. I can't describe the music I'm about to play any more than madness may ensue. So just be prepared for any and everything at this point. This next work is a piccolo trumpet work, and if you've never seen a piccolo trumpet before, it is this little guy. Yeah, Billy took one of my trumpets and stuck it in a dryer and never came back the same. So gotta work with what I got. This trumpet was basically invented during the time of all the crazy Bach and Handel works, because a lot of high notes were there, and guys didn't really want to work all that hard. I call that almost the invention of lazy, but I'm gonna leave that alone for right now. But it's a lot of fun. It gives you a bunch of different colors, and this horn was definitely made famous by the late Maurice Andre. That guy could play a piccolo trumpet. He was like a madman's dream. It was beautiful. That guy played a lot of beautiful work on piccolo trumpet, but there's one particular TV show that makes the piccolo trumpet stand out. Anybody know what it is? I give you a hint, it comes on Sundays. Still no? All right, cool. CBS Sunday Morning, remember that one piccolo trumpet fanfare that happens? I don't know it, I'm not even gonna try to fake like I know it, but I'm not gonna do it for you. But Wynton Marsalis played that piece, and it became quite famous at that point once he recorded it in one take. And ever since then, it's just been a brilliant work. So I'm going to attempt the piccolo trumpet work by Giuseppe Torelli called the Concerto in D. I'm going to do the third movement. It's an allegro. To switch from the smallest to the biggest horn in the collection. Oh, you surprised some people. You know what this is? You know what it's called? Hey, you got some fans out there. All right, that's cool. This horn was invented basically in Austria in around the 1830s. I like to call this one the marriage of a trumpet and a French horn, if you know. Two people playing in the woods, fell in love, this is what happened. So I feel like I have to describe that to a lot of people, but it's fun, it sounds really cool. But this horn never really made it into the mainstream until some of the jazz folks got a hold of it. Jazz and big bands all of a sudden made the flugelhorn very, very famous for some odd reason. There's a particular dude out there somewhere, that happened, that made this thing his instrument. Anybody know who that is? No comments from the peanut gallery up here. Anybody? You can say it out loud, it's cool. We're not really in church. Hey, cool. You win the prize. I don't know what it is yet, but you win the prize. Awesome. Yeah, Chuck Mangione made this horn just, it talked. I don't know, I think a song kind of made, it might have sounded like this. I'm not going to do that to you. I won't tease you like that. Sorry about that, guys. But yeah, Chuck Mangione made this thing. He made it his own, and America was captivated by the fact that a man can make a weird instrument mainstream. And so I'm going to pay tribute to that today. This piece calls for a switch between flugelhorn and trumpet. It was written by a trumpet player, which I think is pretty cool. He got really involved in the classical literature, but there's a certain section in this piece that really reflects on his New York jazz roots. You'll hear it. It's very, very awesome. So any of you trumpet purists in the house, anybody listening online, if the spirit so moves and I go off script, I'm sorry, it just felt right. So anything goes in this work. It's a very long one, so buckle your seatbelts. It's gonna take you on a musical journey. This piece is called Nightsongs. Thank you. Seems like I forgot my air compressor for that last note. Just a word of thanks to First United Methodist of Conway, especially Pastor Kyle and Billy Falau for the use of the fine establishment. I really appreciate you guys a lot. This is great. The experience here has been awesome. Thanks the guy upstairs, Lee. I don't know your last name, but you're awesome. You're a cool dude. Cindy Moore came all the way from Savannah to help live stream the event. That's really, really cool. If any members of Festive Brass are in the house, I'd like to acknowledge you guys for putting up with me as long as you have. It's been a lot of fun. I can't wait to go to Hawaii with you guys. We're gonna absolutely show them what South Carolina can do. Yeah, we've been ignored for far too long, and it's our time to go, you know, put our feet down in the sand, let some people know what we can do. So any members of Festive Brass, thank you guys very much for, you know, helping the word get out. Let's do what we do and keep continuing to move forward. Kate McDaniel, wherever she is, I don't know if she's in the audience or back there somewhere, but wherever you are, Kate, good job. Wow. I had to follow that up. That's an undertaking and a half. Good job to Kate McDaniel for singing the way she did. And I call this one Master Yoda, man. She does some stuff that nobody could ever do on a piano. I think she has like 14 fingers. She's playing a lot of notes that I didn't think existed on the piano, and I just watched her just, you know, turn me from bad to good, and the things I did well, she made better. So I appreciate Jessica Eaton for everything. Like, please give her a round of applause, man. With all that said, this last tune that I'm going to attempt, is a theme and variations based on a piece that was written back in 1880. A guy named Luigi Denza wrote it, based on Funiculi Funicula. It was actually based on a new railway system that had opened. So he took something that was based on a train, and, you know, Herman Belstedt, he came to the U.S., started playing with the John Philip Sousa Band. He made friends with a guy named Herbert L. Clark, and those guys decided to just take on the world and wrote a whole bunch of theme and variations on a whole bunch of different things. And this one came out. I'm pretty sure you'll recognize the tune when you hear it. It's known by a whole bunch of different names. You've probably seen it on some game commercials, food commercials. Trust me, you'll know it when you hear it. This is theme and variations on Napoli. Again, thank you guys so much for braving the elements and coming and hanging out with me for an hour and some change. If you want to talk to me after the show, first, I'll be surprised. And then second of all, like, I'll be available here or back in the lobby, wherever you find me. I'll be glad to entertain any questions you may have about the music or the instruments. Again, thank you all so much and hope you enjoyed the recital. About to happen, it's gonna happen.
Thank you.